this tutorial, I will do an introduction to the libraries. What is a library, where to find the libraries, how to add a library to the project, how use the blocks inside the libraries, and so on. First of all, what is a library? A library is an object that is a collection of function block, and data types. We have already seen that the new project comes with two libraries, the standard and Karel Pico. The standard library contains basic function block like the arithmetic operators, boolean operators, simple counters, simple timers, and so on. And then the Karel Pico that contains function blocks for the CPico platform, like the import-export param that we have seen in the tutorial number 20, function block to read-write system information, to read the real-time clock, and the custom protocols, and so on. And then there is the Karel basic lib. This is not included in your project, we have to download from somewhere, later we will see from where. The Karel basic lib basically extends the previous one with other simple basic generic blocks like AND with more gates, converter, more sophisticated hysteresis function, and so on. This is the chiller alarm, here is the standard library, the Karel Pico library, the Karel basic lib library. And then we have a multitude of libraries that we have logically divided in three categories: the advanced Karel devices and third parties devices. The advanced category contains libraries for specific devices or function, like a function block to manage the envelope and the oil recovery of the compressors, a function block for the rotation of devices, compressors, pumps, fans, whatever else. A library containing a block to manage the defrost in heat pump applications, and so on. Later we will see that there are others. In the Karel devices, we find the libraries to manage the Karel devices, serial probe, the EVD driver, external or embedded, the block to manage the CPCOE, that is the input-output expansion board, and later we will, in the next exercise, next tutorial, we will use this. And then the third part is devices that at the moment contains just two libraries for the IBM PAPST and ZLabig fans. The standard and the Karel Pico libraries correspond more or less to the Atom library in one tool. The Karel basic lib corresponds more or less to the MacroBlocks library, while it is different the structure of the other libraries. In Montool there is one library for all modules, basically for all other blocks. Well, the advantage is that there is just one library, one more library. The disadvantage could be that it contains all modules. For this reason, if you have to update, for example, only the library for the PicoE, you have to update the library. So you will update also all other blocks. So not only the one that you need or you want to update. Someone, maybe most of users, don't like it. They prefer to update only the block that he wants to update, not all others. And this is what we have done in C Suite. So in C Suite there is a multitude of libraries, one for each function, for a specific function or device. For example, talking about this, there is one library containing one block for the serial probe, another library containing another block, actually sometimes there are two or three blocks anyway, so one library for the EVD Evo, another library for the EVD embedded, another library for the CPQE, and so on. So the advantage of this structure is that if you have to update only the block for the CPQE, you have to update a library that contains only the block for the CPQE and not others. So you won't modify the behavior of all other devices of your application. So where are the libraries? Libraries are, of course, in KSA in the C suite area. This is the C suite libraries. In this section, you can find the latest version of the Karel Basic Lib. And then here is the Karel Devices category with all the libraries, the Karel Advanced, third parties. So you have to find the library you are interested in, for example the CPQE2, that is what we will do in the next exercise, download, and then you have to add to your project. We have seen in the very first exercise how to add a library. In the Solution Explorer, right click the project name, add dependency, and select the library. So how to add a library to the project is just one of the operations that you can do with the libraries. In this document you can find all other operations that you can do. At the moment these informations are not in the online or offline help of C Suite, but it is in an independent document. Anyway, it is in KSA, Library Management in C Suite. So here is Library Management in C Suite. So it is a link to the Documents folder, and here is. Okay, I have opened the document. So there is the definition of how many types of libraries we have, how to add, to remove and create libraries, because you can create your library. For example, in the second exercise, we have created the stage 4 direct function block. Well, you could save it in a library, in your library, that you can use in all your other projects. Then how to update, to create a library block, how to open library block, edit, and a lot of other functions. This tutorial is just an introduction to the libraries, so I won't go through this document. The important is that you remember that there is a document that tells you how to work with the libraries. We can see only this part, types of library. There are two types of library, normal and device library. The normal libraries contains just function and function block, like the standard and the Karel Basic Lib. While a device library is a library that contains a function or a function block and also masks, Modbus templates, and so on. And they correspond more or less to the modules block in Modul. Typical example are the ones to manage the device, the field bus devices like the EVD Evo, the BLDC, the CPQE, that is the input-output expansion board, and so on. I wanted to highlight this difference because while use a block of the normal library is simple, just drag and drop, as the conv block, hysteresis block, end block, and so on, for the device library there is a different sequence that is the subject of the next tutorial. So that's all for this tutorial. In the next one we will see how to insert in your application, in an application, a block of a device library type